Credit ratings are a big deal, especially for this administration. With higher credit ratings come more access to affordable loans for government and business. The revision of Fitch Ratings' outlook on the Philippines' credit rating to negative from stable this week is not a welcome development.
Last year, in fact, we downgraded some countries because of the pandemic, and that didn't happen to the Philippines. You know, because as I was saying, there were certain buffers that they had going into the crisis. And now we think those buffers have been eroded, but there is still uncertainty about the evolution of the pandemic.
Nomura's chief ASEAN economist, Eubén Paracuelas, says the outlook revision is a negative surprise to investors, especially since the Duterte economic team was trying to minimize ratings pressures through fiscal conservatism or prudence. Paracuelas noted Fitch even highlighted that the Philippines' fiscal position has weakened in spite of that effort, and part of the reason was the impact of the CREATE law, which lowers corporate income taxes. The Bureau of Internal Revenue, the government's main tax collection arm, recently issued a new revenue regulation imposing 12% value-added tax on certain goods and services which were previously exempt. This took effect on June 27th. Foreign investors, exporters, and manufacturers, however, expect the move will actually lower tax revenues because it will scare off investors.
So I don't know why Philippine government or BIR issued this kind of things. This is a quite negative, you know. Automatically, our company, you know, manufacturing company like Samsung and SFA Semiconductor, report to the headquarters, and then the response from headquarters is quite negative. What are you, doing there?
The BIR says it is working with the Department of Finance to address the issues raised on RR9-2021, and the BIR expects results in at least 2 weeks. The Trade Department, meanwhile, is set to meet with exporters this week to discuss the same. As for the negative outlook from Fitch, Socioeconomic Planning Secretary Carl Chua says the fact Fitch retained the BBB rating for the Philippines is a vote of confidence in their economic and fiscal management. Central Bank Governor Benjamin Jokno says the acceleration of the vaccination program should help strengthen the economic recovery, and the Philippines' solid fundamentals and reform initiatives should carry the Philippines to a solid rebound. Finance Secretary Carlos Dominguez, meanwhile, says the COVID relief measures remain adequate and have actually been augmented significantly while still remaining within the boundaries of fiscal discipline. The economic team expects the economy will still grow by between 6 and 7% this year and between 7 and 9% in 2022. Warren De Guzman, ABS-CBN News.